Hello guys, welcome to science education. Write the notes, remaining points. Write down. While going from left to right within the period, the atomic number increases by one at a time, and the number of valence electrons also increases. Next point, write the question. Explain about the groups of modern periodic table. Right answer. Point first. Groups are numbered from 1 to 18. Groups are numbered from 1 to 18. Next point. Group number 1 contains alkali metals. Group number 2 contains alkaline earth metals. Group 17 contains halogens. Group 18 contains inert gases. Next point. Metals are present on the left hand side of the periodic table. Whereas non-metals are present on the right hand side of the periodic table. Next point. Elements present in group first and second, in group first and second on the left side and 13 to 17 on the right side of the periodic table, are called normal elements. Next point, elements present in groups 3 to 12 in the middle of the periodic table are called as transition elements. Next point, elements placed at the bottom of the periodic table are called as inner transition elements. That is, lanthanides and actinides. Next point, group number 18 on the extreme right of the periodic table contains inert gases. Their outermost shell contains 8 electrons. Next point, the entire periodic table is divided into four blocks. S block, P block, D block and F block. All right, next question. Write down the blockwise classification of elements in modern periodic table. Right answer. first point. Elements in the modern periodic table. Elements in the modern periodic table are classified on the basis of their THEIR, their electronic configuration, they are divided into four blocks: S block, P block, D block and F block. Next point. Groups first and second are included in S block all these elements are metals. These elements contain Next point. Groups 13 to 18 group elements are included in P block They contain 3 to 8 electrons in their outermost shell. P block contains metals, non-metals and metalloids. Next point. Elements from S block and P block are called as normal elements. These elements have outermost shell incomplete. Except 18 group elements. Next point. Groups 3 to 12. 3 to 12 are known as D block elements. Known as D block elements. They are known as transition elements. Transition, TRANSITION. Transition elements. Underline this word. All these elements are metals. These elements have two outermost shells incomplete. Next point. Lanthanide and actinide series. They are called as inner transition elements. Underline. They have three incomplete outermost shells they are metals. Next point. Then, write new point. Give the heading. Groups and electronic configuration. Write first point. Elements having same number of valence electrons are present in the same group. Next point. Elements present in the same group Various properties of all the elements in a group show similarity and gradation. Similarity and gradation. Next point. While going from top to bottom within any group, one electronic shell gets added at a time. And number of shells goes on increasing. Then next point, the chemical reactivity of an element is determined by the number of valence electrons in it and the shell number of the valence shell. Then, next point, write a short note on a zigzag line. Zigzag, Z-I-G-Z-A-G, zigzag line. Right answer. First point. A zigzag line can be drawn in the P block of the modern periodic table. Next point. The three traditional types. The three traditional types of elements. Three traditional types of elements can be clearly shown. Can be clearly shown in the modern periodic table. In the modern periodic table, with the help of zigzag line, with the help of zigzag line. Next point. The metalloid elements. The metalloid elements lie, L-I-E, along the border of the zigzag line. Along the border of the zigzag line. Next point. All the metals lie. All the metals lie on the left side of the zigzag line. On the left side of the zigzag line, while all the non-metals lie on the right side. Next point. Boron, silicon, germanium, arsenic, tellurium, polonium are the examples of metalloids. Okay guys. Next point we'll start tomorrow. Thank you.